I'm Anton Troyanovsky, Moscow bureau chief for the Washington Post, and I recently visited a farm in Russia's southern district of Ust-Labinsk. It's surrounded by a perimeter fence, but otherwise, it is not an ostentatious farm. You couldn't be blamed if you drove right by it, never knowing that it's owned by one of the world's richest men. Russian aluminum tycoon Oleg Deripaska grew up in this area. He still calls it home. The world knows Deripaska as an exceedingly wealthy businessman with alleged ties to Russian meddling in the US's 2016 presidential election. He's been spotted in a video relaxing on a yacht with a Russian deputy prime minister and a self-identified sex trainer who claimed to have incriminating information about President Trump. But on this farm, they worry more about how Deripaska likes his sausage than his boating companions or business dealings. The US Treasury says that Deripaska has been accused of extortion, racketeering, and even threatening the lives of his business rivals, all of which he denies. But when it comes to food, he's conservative. On Deripaska's farm, dairy and beef cows receive individual attention and care. Chickens get to walk outside for fresh air. Orchards feature 56 varieties of apples, and the greenhouse abounds with fresh produce. A lot of what doesn't make it to Deripaska's table gets sold in town. The farm manager says Deripaska is thinking of expanding the efforts here. But the US Treasury has made things more complicated. While Washington recently lifted sanctions on Deripaska's companies, he still can't do business with Americans. The farm has had trouble servicing its Western equipment as a result, and sanctions contributed to Deripaska's wealth being almost cut in half in 2018, according to Forbes. But with more than $3.5 billion still to his name, it's unlikely that this cash cow will run dry anytime soon.